What's up? Welcome to another edition of Daily 5. You all know who I am. Let's get into it. So the first one is going to be the race beginning, or in this case, the presidential race. I'm glad that Seth Meyers sees Miss Oprah in the same way I see her. Yes, I'm late on reporting this, but as I may mention on yesterday's show, I have been busy playing catch up with all the shows and getting things ready for you guys. Anyway, I am with Myers on Madam President Winfrey. However, while I respect Tom Hanks, I am sticking with my decision about Madam President Hillary being Madam President-elect Oprah's Vice President. You all are probably wondering, Mike, why are you suggesting that Hillary step down from being president to allow Oprah to be president? It sounds like that. That's why. But that's what I'm sticking with, because I want Oprah to be in the spot. Since we know that to some people his name is Cheeto, to me is Hitler or Donald Hitler. A guy who should not be in the Oval Office, who happens to be in the Oval Office, for those of you in the hood who have no idea who I'm talking about, somehow. Yeah. The reason why I refer to Hillary as Madam President is because, from my vantage point, that's who the president is, not this weird guy. Anyway. Since I have stuck with Madam President Hillary, that's all there is to it. So for 2020, for us at Video Network, especially for myself, the ticket is Winfrey Clinton 2020. Number two, BJP infighting. So the Bharatiya Janata Party, or the BJP, are at it again. Rika Verma of Madhya Pradesh and Shashank Trivedi of the legislative branch of the BJP got into a heated disagreement recently while handing out blankets to the media at the Mohai Tehsil office. The cause of the argument seems to be that both Verma and Trivedi wanted the credit for the act. You would think that Brother Trivedi, would be gracious and allow Sister Verma to take credit for the blanket, for handing out the first blanket, and let himself take the second blanket. But no! Shashank had to fight with Rika over first place and ultimately make the entire Bharatiya Janata Party look bad altogether. Next time, Shashank, just let Rika go first. Get seriously. Just let me stay and let the sister go first. Just chill. Anyway, number three. Wardrobe malfunction. This is an interesting one. In Quetzalcoatl, El Salvador, pardon if I mispronounced it, which I probably did, my apologies. A beauty pageant contestant came very close to getting burnt, and the headdress of her Queen Harvest costume got a little too close to a torch a brother was holding, causing the feathers of the headdress to instantly go ablaze. Clearly, brother was hypnotized by Sister Beauty to the point that he didn't see the need to move to the right side because she was coming from behind on his left-hand side. We are glad that Sister's not seriously injured, but we would advise in the future that the Queen Harvest headdress be kept very far away from the torches. Number four, to each her own struggle. While it's good to hear the government of Arabia is going to allow women to drive in June of this Gregorian year, or I believe it's Rabi 2, if I'm not mistaken. I couldn't, don't have the calendar in front of me, but the Arabic equivalent of June. That's what I'm trying to say. Anyway, what is not so good is the ban in Arabia on women driving being used by women in non-Muslim countries as a sign of oppression. Just as women in Persia, or some call it Iran today, are taking off their hijabs to address Persian issues, women wanting the right to drive a car in Arabia belongs only to the women of Arabia. Women in other countries, and particularly European and or white women, should stop trying to merge their issues with men in their countries with the issues of women in Muslim countries. Muslimas or Muslim women issues with oppression are based in Islam. What Quran says versus what men of today believe that Rasulullah or that Muhammad said. Non-Muslim women's issues with oppression are not based in religion. Non-Muslim women are dealing with unpious men or unrighteous men, unrighteous in the heart, who generally have no respect or regard for women because these men were taught by their fathers that they didn't necessarily have to respect women. The non-Muslim man is not concerned with what the gospel say or even what God says. Arabian and Persian men may have warped understanding of what Quran says, but at least they're attempting to practice what God says. Can the same be said for non-Muslim men? Or for men in non-Muslim countries? Number 5. Hitler and his promises or his lies. It seems that Donald is at it again. Hitler is so focused on keeping his campaign lie of building a wall between the United States and Mexico and forcing the Mexican government to pay for Donald's idea that Donald forced a government shutdown altogether. John Kelly is trying to be the voice of reason to Hitler, which is really interesting and just weird in a presidential situation, mind you. I have no love for the presidency of the United States whatsoever, but I do find it interesting that the president needs a voice of reason in any situation. Isn't the president supposed to be the voice of reason? So yes, Kelly is trying to be the voice of reason to Hitler and make sure Hitler understands that he will not be able to literally keep his promise to his supporters about having a wall built. What is sad is that no matter how ridiculous Hitler speaks, no matter what insane act Donald does, his supporters will stick by his side because Donald's supporters really, truly would rather have the United States filled with a majority of dead corpses due to very avoidable issues. They would rather kill the majority of the U.S., and possibly the world, rather than accept the days of the white man ruling are at an end. Sometimes I really do feel for white men of the U.S. I said sometimes. No, I'm sorry. Sometimes. Anyway. As always, click the red button for subscribe. Like it if you like it. Comment down below. Do that. And I'm out.